8mm, Wikipedia Article Audio. 8mm is a 1999 crime mystery film directed by Joel Schumacher and written by Andrew Kevin Walker. The film stars Nicolas Cage as a private investigator who delves into the world of snuff films. Joaquin Phoenix, James Gandolfini, Peter Stormer, and Anthony Heald appear in supporting roles. Private investigator Tom Wells is contacted by Daniel Longdale, attorney for wealthy widow Mrs. Christian, whose husband has recently died. While clearing out her late husband's safe, she and Longdale find an 8mm movie which appears to depict a real murder of a girl, but Mrs. Christian wants to know for certain. Wells is bound by obligation from both Longdale and Mrs. Christian not to reproduce the film in any way, and that only they need to know about the investigation. After looking through a missing person's files, Wells discovers the girl is Marianne Matthews and visits her mother, Janet Matthews. While searching the house with her permission, he finds Marianne's diary, in which she says she went to Hollywood to become a film star. He asks Mrs. Matthews if she wants to know the truth, even if it is the worst. She says that she wants to know what happened to her daughter. In Hollywood, with the help of an adult video store employee called Max California, Wells delves into the world of underground fetish pornography. He attempts to find out if snuff is indeed real, or if there was anyone in this underworld who was connected to this film. Contact with a sleazy talent scout named Eddie Poole leads them to director Dino Velvet, whose violent pornographic films star a masked man known as Machine. To gain more evidence, Wells pretends to be a client interested in commissioning a hardcore bondage film to be directed by Velvet and starring Machine. Velvet agrees and arranges a meeting in New York City. The meeting turns out to be an ambush. Longdale and Poole appear and hold Wells at gunpoint. Longdale tipped off Velvet and Poole that Wells was onto them. It's now clear that the film was real. Mr. Christian contacted Longdale to procure a snuff film, and being unable to find one, he commissioned Velvet and Poole to make one. Velvet and Machine produce a bound and beat in California, whom they abducted to force Wells to bring them the only surviving copy of the illegal film. Longdale and Wells go to Wells' car to retrieve the film, in which Longdale admits that he never thought Wells would get as far as he did, and just wanted to placate Mrs. Christian with the investigation. Once he delivers it, they burn it and kill California. As they are about to kill Wells, he tells them that Mr. Christian paid $1 million for the film. Velvet, Poole, and Machine received $50,000 and that Longdale kept the major portion. In an ensuing fight, Velvet and Longdale are both killed, Wells wounds Machine and escapes. Wells calls Mrs. Christian to tell her his discoveries and recommends going to the police, to which she agrees. Arriving at her estate, Wells is told that Mrs. Christian committed suicide after hearing the news. She left envelopes for the Matthews family and Wells. It contains the rest of his payment and a note reading, "Try to forget us." Wells warns his already frantic wife of the impending danger and to seek shelter in a location known only to them, and hands her his half of the money. Wells decides to seek justice for the murdered girl by killing the remaining people involved. Tracking down Poole, Wells takes him to the shooting location and tries to kill him. He can't bring himself to do it amid Poole's taunting, and steps out of the house. He calls Mrs. Matthews to tell her about her daughter and asks for her permission to punish those responsible. "Just tell me that you loved her." Mrs. Matthews breaks down in hysterics once presented with the truth, but affirms that she loved her daughter. With that, Wells returns and beats Poole to death with his pistol, burning his body and the pornography from his car. Wells traces Machine and attacks him at his home. Wells unmasks him, revealing a bald, bespectacled man named George. He reveals to Wells that he has no ulterior motive for his sadistic actions, he does them simply because he enjoys it. They struggle, and Wells kills him. After returning to his family, Wells breaks down in front of his wife as he tries to process all of the evil that he had seen over the course of the investigation. Months later, Wells receives a letter from Mrs. Matthews, thanking him and suggesting he and she were the only ones to care about Marianne. 8mm opened in 2,730 theaters in North America and made $14,252,888 in its opening weekend with an average of $6,013 per theater, ranking number one at the box office. The film made $36,663,315 domestically and $59,955,384 internationally for a total of $96,618,699, more than double its $40 million production budget. The film received negative reviews from critics. It has a rating of 22% on Rotten Tomatoes based on 82 reviews with an average rating of 4.21/10. The consensus states that its sadistic violence is unappealing and is lacking in suspense and mystery. The film also has a score of 19 out of 100 on Metacritic based on 20 reviews indicating overwhelming dislike. Derek Ellie of Variety criticized the film, stating that 8mm is a movie that keeps jumping the gate and finally unravels all over the floor. Roger Ebert was one of the film's admirers and gave the film 3 stars out of 4, stating on his website, "I know some audience members will be appalled by this film, as many were by 7. It is a very hard R that would doubtless have been NC-17 if it had come from an indie instead of a big studio with clout. But it is a real film. Not a slick exploitation exercise with all the trappings of depravity but none of the consequences. Not a film where moral issues are forgotten in the excitement of an action climax. Yes, the hero is an ordinary man who finds himself able to handle violent situations, but that's not the movie's point. The last 2 words of the screenplay are "save me," and by the time they're said, we know what they mean. The film score was composed by Mike Cialdana. It was released on CD by Chapter III in 1999, with a total of 20 tracks.